Welcome to part two. In this part, we are going to look at basically how you can divide the beat into triplets and semi-quavers or 16th notes. 16th notes divide the beat by four generally, eighth notes divide by two. That I've already taught you in part one. If you've stumbled on this video and haven't watched part one, please head over there and watch part one, where I've even taught how to count these subdivisions. So moving on to triplets. So how it works here is, to refresh your memory, we are taking three notes, which in a normal world of no beat division would have ended up being this. One, two, three, four, right? Nothing fancy, because there's no division to deal with. But now if you divide by three, you count, maybe you count while playing the same thing. 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2. To say 3, we can use 1 and a 2 and a, it's just easy on the tongue. So everyone uses this sort of now globally. So 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a, you can even say it faster. Tuck, tuck, 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a duck, 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 right? So now you decide where you want to place your hits. So if you see pattern number one, I've deliberately not used notation for triplets and sixteens because a lot of my followers don't read sheet music. So I don't want to confuse you. Rather, I've just put arrows to show you where exactly the spot lies. Normally, it would have lied at 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. But now, if you see pattern one, 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a... So when you do the and of the 2, it just gives you that very folk or that very Indian groove. So you can build a melody just on the and of the 2. 1 and a 2. Changing the notes if you want. Of course, I got carried away, but you get the idea. And whatever I did, even though I did kind of take a diversion there, I did not take a diversion with respect to the time feel. I was still in the world of triplets or the grouping of triplets. So counting triplets, that was exercise one. Also good to sing it sometimes, take a distance away from the piano, and you can practice it like on your balcony or walking your pet, whatever it might be. And I also make up these additional ghost syllables like tum tum pum tum. I would recommend you could also do it because it helps you to count it and navigate and find where you are in the bar easily. Otherwise, just going pum pum, it just kind of gives you a shock. So I'd rather go tunk 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 tunk, just make some other noises and then go tunk tum pum 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 pum. Whatever you want to do, whatever you can do or anything, right? Moving on to next pattern, I'm having some fun at the three, wherein it's the and of the three. So how does that work?
1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4.
There we go. I'm playing it loudly to demonstrate. You don't have to actually play it loud. Of course, in this lesson, we are still focused on D, E, F, E, as I've even shown you in part one. Coming to pattern number three, which I think is quite cool. On of the one, and of the one. One and, two and, a three and, ta-tan, and of the four. So, ta-na, ta-tan, ta-tan, ta-na, ta-tan. Got that? One and, a two and, a ta-tan. Encourage you to improvise and try to be as creative as possible within the framework of the beats. Okay, so fourth rhythm which you see there, which will be on of the one, of the one, of the two, and the on of the three, and then you wait for the four to end. So that'll be one and a two and a three and a four and a one and a two and a three and a four. Get used to it a bit slower. Right? It's rather tricky, even for me. You have to, it's a very new pattern. So any new pattern, go to the very beginning, try clapping it, slow it down, and then bring it up to speed once your brain enjoys it. Okay, so one and a two and a three and a four and na 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 na. Internalize it. One and a two and a change it. One and a two and a three and a four and one and a two and a three and a four and a one and a two. Tough to count and play, but you get the idea. Stay there. Play whatever you want. Cut it. Two and a three and a four. Even if you stop playing, keep the count going. And a two and a three and a four and a one. And a two and a three and a four. And a two and a three and a four. And a two and a three. And then bring in the melody. Last one on the triplets, then we move into 16s. So you go, as you can see there, one and a two and a three and a four and. So and of the three, and means the middle triplet division. So one and a two and a three and a four and a one and a two and a three and a four. So a very important thing when you're practicing these subdivisions, your body needs to be in a state of excitement when you deal with them. If it is not in that state of excitement, the lazier energy will be more for the on beats, like one, two, three, four, but one and a two and a three and a four. And there's some kind of excitement. I don't know how to really explain it. It's sort of like you've just got a small like jolt or some kind of a shock just came to you, you know. Like that, you know, you just get startled a bit. So that's how you practice the subdivision. Some people try to make the subdivisions easy. Well, easy may not be the right operating word. It may be so that you have to make it exciting for you. Because if it is not exciting for your own mind and body, how is the audience who's going to listen to you want to dance? They are not going to feel that energy which you would need to send to them. So you need to be feel excited when you play subdivisions. Very important. So your mindset also needs to be such that whenever you have an offbeat, feel some kind of excitement. Two, one and a two and a three and a four and a one and a two and a three and a bam. And a two and a three and bam. So those are all about triplets. I hope these five workouts would be nice for you to then continue your journey with triplets. You saw what I did. I put four arrows in a grid, which gives us the opportunity to put 12 arrows if we want. But I'm limiting it to four. As I generally tell people with respect to creating melodies or grooves in general, divide more, play less. You don't want to divide by 3 and then do dung, 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 dung. You don't want all those divisions. You're trying to build a house with gaps so you can walk around as well, right? So you need gaps. So tung, 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 tung. Play 4, but have the opportunity to play 12 or have the possibility of playing 12. That's important. Let's now move into semi-quavers. I have 5 exciting rhythms for you in that system as well. Right, so 16th notes, also called as semi-quavers, divide the beat into 4 units. As I told you in part 1, you go 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E. You get all these exciting divisions. You have 1 on beat for every beat. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. Then you have the and then each, and 1E. Everything feels different on the body, and so it should. Okay? So, the first rhythm you have printed there would be, okay, let's reset our mind by going. While you demonstrate this, try to go 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a. Now, the second note, 1E and a 2E, came at the of the 1, if you see pattern number 1 or row 1. 1E and a 2E and a. 1E and a 2E and of the 2, E of the, sorry, a of the 1. 1E and a 2E and a. 1E and a 2E and a 3 and a 4E. 1E and a 2E and a 3. On of the 3, on of the 1. And a 2E and a 3. That's the pattern. Same melody. Keep the pulse in the left hand. And a 2E and a 3 and a 4E and a 1E and. Second rhythm now for you. Again, try to count it first or do beat by beat. Pause it and then piece the whole thing together. Next one is 1E and a 2E and a 3E and. Okay, I'll just do the first two. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and. Just do that. 1E and a 2E and a. Forget the rest. 1E and a 2E. Now, I'm trying to hunt the a of the 2, which is 1E and a 2E and a 3 and a 4E. Ignore the last one. Out, out. 1E and a 2E and a 3. Now, 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and. Was rhythm 2. Again, feel that excitement. You have to feel the excitement. I don't know why everyone reacts differently. You see my expressions, I mean, for some of you it looks very weird and sometimes a bit funny or whatever it may be, but I can't help it. That's how I react when I'm. So how I react to 16th notes will be very different than how I react to triplets or 8th notes. The body will just do different things. And even you have to let yourself loose when you play these things. You can't do it in a very studious environment. Yes, start studious, but it has to graduate to something musical because music is to entertain people. Okay, the third rhythm now, which will be quite cool. Let's get acquainted. 1E and a 2E and a 3 and a. Just the E of the 2. That's all you deal with, okay? 1E and a 2E and a 3. Make the boom, chicka boom, chicka boom, chicka chicka bam, chicka boom. Again, I repeat, I'm doing this on the piano. You can do this on anything. You can sing it, you can drum it, you can do it on the violin, whatever you want. fourth rhythm for us now. 1E and a 2E and. Okay, now I've kind of cramped up 3 in the space of the 2 beat. So let's see how that works. 1E and a 2E and a. And wait, there's a gap. 1E and a 2E and a. 1E and a 2E. There's a gap at the 3 or. 1E and a 2E and a. You can leave the gap. 1E and a 2E and a. Or hold it on. 1E, hold the last note. 1E and a 2E and a. Wait. 1E and a 2E and a. Why I gave you this rhythm is 1E and a 2E and a. It forces you to count better. And a 2E and a 3 and a. So I've cramped up 1E and a 2E and a 3 and a nothing there. 1E and a 2E and a 3. Okay. 2E and a 3 and nothing there from the 3 onwards. Last rhythm for 16s, guys. So we wait now. Instead of bringing everything to 2, I've kind of brought it off to the 3. So that'll be 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a. Always count the 16s. Very, very important. Right, guys? So far we've just pretty much taken these 3 notes, D, E, F, we've repeated the E, we've done it with triplet patterns and 16 note patterns. Just a couple of points to leave you with from this lesson, or this two-part lesson as it's ended up becoming, would be, what if the time signature changed? Just to give you a little bit of a push in that direction. Let's say your time signature was 3/4. 1, 2, 3. One, so you could do a 3 time signature, but still you can play the same 4 notes, right? Maybe with 3/4, 3/4, 2, 3, I will divide by 4. So meter is 3, time signature is 3, but division of each beat is 4. So how do we do that? 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 1E and a 2E. So now, let's say I strike the 1E and a, 1E and a 2E, 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a. I'll do the on of 1, the and a of 1, 1E and a 2E and of 2, and the E of 3. Sounds confusing even for me. Let me break this down again. So you go 1E and a 2, okay, a 1, a of the 1, 1E and a 2E. 1E and a 2E and a 3E. So on, so you go on, a and E, on, a and a, on, a and E, in, a and E. This is also what we call as the dotted feel. So 1E and a 2E and a 3E and 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E, 1E and a 2E. But the signature is 1, 2, 3, right? Interesting for maybe some of you advanced or intermediate guys out there. So 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a. It actually becomes a polyrhythm if you think about it. 4 in that hand and 3 in this hand, for your information. Okay, again, some more food for thought would be creating longer melodies using this concept. So let's say you do dividing by 2, but now you pick any of those rhythms which we've done in the past. Maybe divide by 2 and do second bar. Something different. One and. Displace the 2, right? It creates some longer melodies, like. Triplets. Thank you. and so on. So take one simple bar, maybe tang 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 ta da ta da, something like that. So simple and then something else. So that way you piece two bars of music together which are still in the same time feel. So that's some more food for thought. You can also, you must have seen, I've been doing some stuff with my left hand. You don't have to just keep playing the D. You can change it around. So explore the scale. A few tips while harmonizing. You see what melody you're playing here and maybe choose one of those notes. Like I'm choosing D here. C. Or whichever note you want to, you decide is important. Maybe you could go up or down a third. D's upper third is F or B flat. That way you get some nice harmony, or just play chords. Essential for this lesson, but just something to keep in mind. You may have seen some of what I played sounded a bit more spicy, so those are things you could consider. Right, guys? So again, in this two-part lesson, we've looked at how to build melodic phrases or riffs on the piano using subdivisions and just three notes. Just three notes, D, E, and F. So what did we do? We looked at quavers, eighth notes, dividing by two. Then we looked at triplets, where the beat structure is divided by three. Then we looked at semi-quavers or 16th notes, where the beat structure is divided by four. We have more slots to fill, but yet we just say I'm going to play four always. And those were all the exercises which we have. So all of these notated exercises are on the Patreon. You could check it out in the description or wherever. You just have to go to Patreon and you can find me there. And you will get all the handwritten notes, notation, whenever we do notation, backing tracks, MP3s, whenever it needs it. And also, it'll keep happening. So the next lessons, we'll keep putting it up on that Patreon page. It's just $5 a month and your support for our channel will be great as well. Right? And if you're watching this lesson, if you're still watching, it's great. But if you haven't subscribed, that may not be that great because there's a lot more videos coming your way. So hit that subscribe button, hit the bell icon. It's not only important to hit the subscribe, also hit the bell, because we do a lot of lessons and you will get a notification whenever the new one comes up. And when it does pop up on your YouTube feed, you can decide to watch it or whatever. Right? Thanks again for watching this lesson and I will see you in the next one. Cheers.